Hi, I'm Peter, and this is a brief demonstration of the trim and trace functions. So if I want to remove a part of a profile, I can use the trim function. So first I select the profile by left clicking it with the mouse, and then I select the trim function, and here you can see that the cursor is snapping to the profile. And I go with the mouse where I want to start trimming. I click the left mouse button. And the red line shows which part of the profile will be trimmed. And again, I click the left mouse button. And you see the section has been removed. Now, let's go back. Let's say I want to replicate part of a profile, or this could be also used to join acquired profiles into one. So I can use the trace function here. And let me just show you how to replicate. Let's say I want to mark that this profile is glazed. So I want to make a parallel line that copies the profile. So I left click here where I want to start. Just move it again. It snaps automatically to the profile, so I don't have to go exactly with the mouse along the profile. And again, left click where I want to finish. And I can choose whether this should be now the main profile or the detail. In this case, I want the detail. OK. And the line is drawn here, but it's aligned with the profile, so I can just left click and drag and do this rubber band selection to select both the profile and the detail. And now when I click and drag it, I can move the new detail, separate it from the profile, and use it like this. I can again, if I want to shorten this, I can use the trim function on it to adjust part of it. So this is a way to rudimentary way edit the profiles. I can also use the trace function to reconstruct or to create or edit part of the profile. Let's say if I have a rim that's not properly captured and I want to retrace it. Then I can use the trace function again to copy the part that's okay. Going with the mouse around it. I can zoom in here. And now I hold down the Alt button. And that releases the snapping to the profile, and I can just draw with the mouse and then release the Alt button again so it snaps back to the profile and finish the drawing. I say it's the profile this time. And it's far from perfect, but I can use the smooth function to smooth it out. Yeah, so I guess, of course, in this case, it would be better to recapture the profile, but just to demonstrate this function. So this way you can draw with the trace function. So that concludes the trim and trace tutorial.